Good morning, children. Hope all are doing good. Everybody are safe and healthy. Very good. All right. Now today we are going to deal with your new chapter division. As I have said you already, I have informed you previously. Like if you have to do the multiplications or divisions, what are you need to be perfect with? Tables. Until and unless you are not learning the tables, it will not be very much easy to do the multiplications or the divisions. All right. Now we learned multiplication is a repeated addition. Repeated addition is called as multiplication. Now, quite opposite to that is division. So, what do you mean by division? Division means it's a repeated subtraction. Repeated subtraction is called as division. Alright. Now let us see, in this chapter you're learning how to do the divisions using repeated subtraction, using a number line and long division method. But before that, children, you need to be very perfect with the table. So to your class or to your standard, you need to be very much perfect from 2 till 15 tables. So if you are perfect with these tables, you can do the divisions very easy. Okay, shall we start the chapter? Alright, now see from your textbook in your exercise 2.1. So we'll be discussing exercise wise. Okay, now see in your 2.1, you have subtractions. You have subtractions and you have to find out the quotient using repeated subtraction. So what is this repeated subtraction? Let us see with the problem. Now you have 27 divided by 9. 27 divided by 9. Alright. Now, here you are going to find out the quotient. Now, what do you mean by quotient, children? Already you knew that very well. So, whatever the final answer we are getting on dividing is nothing but the quotient. Like this, like in multiplication, what do we say the final answer or the final result as? Product. So similarly, the final result or the final answer while doing the division is called as the quotient. Okay, and few more new terms are there that slowly we will be seeing when we are doing in the long division method. Okay, now let us see, 27 divided by 9, we have to find out the quotient using the method repeated subtraction. Now what do you mean by repeated subtraction? It means you are subtracting repeatedly. Now from 27 you have to subtract 9 till you get the answer as 0. What are you doing? You are subtracting 9 from 27 till you get the answer as 0. What do you mean by this? Now let us see while solving this problem. Now from 27 minus 9. Alright, from 7 we cannot take away 9. So we are taking a borrow. 17 minus 9, 8, 1. What is the answer we got? 18. Again from 18 we are subtracting 9. 18 minus 9, 9. Again from 9 we are subtracting 9. So our final answer is 0. Yes, this is called as the repeated subtraction. Why only 9 you are subtracting, children? Because here we have given 27 divided with 9. So we are subtracting 9 repeatedly until we are getting the answer as 0. Now how many times did we subtracted 9, children? 1, 2, 3. So on subtracting 9, 3 times we got our answer as 0. Therefore, 27 divided by 9 is 3. Got it? Now, 27 divided with 9 is equal to 3. In this, 27 is called as the dividend. The number which we are dividing is called as the dividend. And 9 is called as the divisor. 9 is called as the divisor. The number which the dividend is being divided is called as the divisor. And the answer is called as the quotient. So what is 3 called as? question. And what is left over here? Zero. That is remainder. Got it? So this is what repeated subtraction means. So how we are getting 3? We are subtracting 9 how many times? 3. On subtracting 9, 3 times, our result is 0. Therefore, 27 divided with 9 is equal to 3. Got it? Now let us take another problem. So let us see the another problem. 35 divided with 7. Alright. Now, so what are you going to do? We are going to subtract 7 from 35 repeatedly till we are getting the answer as 0. Okay. Now, 35 minus 7. So from 5, we cannot take away 7. So what are we doing? We are taking a borrow. 15 minus 7. 8, drop 2 down. Again from 28, minus 7. 8 minus 7, 1. And 2, drop it down. Again, 21 minus 7. So from 1, we cannot take away 7. Therefore, borrow. 11 minus 7, 4, 1 as it is. Again from 14, 7. 14 minus 7, 7. Again from 7, 0. So we are repeatedly subtracting the number. Now how many times did we subtract 7 children? Let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many times did we subtract 7 from 35 to get 0? 5 times. So what is our quotient? 5. 35 divided with 7 is 5. On subtracting 7 from 35 5 times, our answer is 0. Now here, what is the dividend? 35 is the dividend, 7 is the divisor, and 5 is the quotient. Understood, children? So this is finding out a quotient using repeated subtraction. Now let us see how to divide and find the quotient using the number line. Already you are very well versed with the number line. Yes, so you learned addition using number line, subtractions using number line, multiplication using number line, and now we are learning divisions using the number line. So the concept is same. In multiplications, to find out the product, what are you doing? You're jumping forward. But since we learned division is opposite of multiplication, so here what are we doing? We will take the jumps from the backward. It means we'll be jumping from back to front. Backward jumping will be there in the divisions using the number line. Forward jumping will be there in the multiplications using number line. Okay, now let us see. Let us take 18 divided by 3. Alright, now let us draw a number line. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Because our dividend is 18, so we will write till 18 or more than 18, it is up to you children. 19, 20. Okay, let us draw the number line from 0 till 20. So we know very well a number line starts with 0 or 1. Yes, it starts with 0. Alright, now in multiplication, what we used to do? We used to take jumps from forward, from left to right. But in division, we are taking the backward jump. Alright, now 18 divided by 3, how many jumps we are going to take? 3. Because our divisor is 3. Now see children, from 18 I have to start. Because my dividend is 18, therefore from 18 I am starting. From 18, how many jumps we need to take? 3. 1, 2, 3. So till 15. Again 1, 2, 3. So from 15 till 12. Again from 12. 1, 2, 3. 9. From 9. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So we are stopping till 0. Now how many times we have taken? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how many jumps we have taken, children? 6. So 18 divided by 3 is equal to 6. Since here we have our divisor is 3. Therefore, we are skipping 3 numbers. From 18, you will be counting 1, 2, 3. And a jump. Again, 1, 2, 3. Another jump. Like you are taking jumps till you reach 0. So we are taking here the backward jump, not the forward jump. Now let us take another example. So we'll be doing the division using the number line. Let us see with the other example. 20 divided by 2. 20 divided by 2. Come on again. Draw a number line. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. Now we are going to find out the quotient for this problem, 20 divided by 2, using the number line. So from where we need to start? Is it from the beginning or from the last, children? From the last. From where we have to start? From 20. Why only 20? Why not the other number? Because our dividend given is 20. Since our dividend is 20, we are starting from 20. Okay, and we stop here 0. Got it? Now from 20, how many numbers we need to skip? 2 numbers, because our divisor is 2. Now from 20, 1, 2. Again, 1, 2. Again, 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. Sorry. Here. 1, 2. Again. 1, 2. Got it? Now how many jumps we have taken? Come on, count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many jumps we have taken? 10. So what is our quotient? 10. Got it? So this is how you are finding the quotient using the number line. Understood, children? So you are jumping from last to front. But in multiplication, from first to last. But in division, from last to first. That is the only difference. Okay? So here it completes till your exercise 2.2. Now here in your exercise 2.3, what are we learning? Now here you are learning, using the given multiplication fact, you have to write two division facts, like two division statements. Let us see that. What do you mean by a multiplication fact, children? Multiplication fact is nothing but a multiplication statement, like 2 3s are 6. 4 2s are 8, whatever is it. Okay, now let us take 12 into 7 is 84. Now this is called as a multiplication fact. So here we have given the multiplication fact. For every multiplication fact, we will be having two division facts. Okay, what are that? Now, 84, what are we doing? Divided with 12. 84 divided with 12, what is the number left over? 7. Similarly, 84 divided with 7, what is the number left over? 12. Simple it is. Using the multiplication fact, you are writing division fact. Now you know very well table 12. 12, 84 in 12, how many times? 7 times. 84 in 7, how many times? 12 times. As it is, 7 12s are is 84. 12 7s are is also 84. That is commutative property, what we learned in your multiplication. On changing the order of the numbers while multiplying, the product remains the same. Got it? So that formula here. Now 12 into 7, what are we doing first? 84 divided with 12. Leftover number is 7. Again 84 divided with 7. Leftover number is 12. So these are the two division facts for the given multiplication fact. Now let us take the other one. 3 8s are 24. Now what are the two division facts? 24 divided with 3. First I take 3. So what is the number left over? 8. Now already we have taken 3. Now let us take 8. 24 divided with 8. What is the number left over? 3. So these are the two division facts for given multiplication fact. Got it, children? This is about it. Okay, next you have find the quotient. Now, for these questions, to find the quotient, you need to be very well perfect with the tables, because these you are going to solve using your mind, imagination skills. Now, here you have to use your imagination skills. How you will be using the imagination? How can we use? Simple it is, if you are very perfect with the tables, it is very easy for us to imagine how many times the divisor in the dividend or how many times the dividend in the divisor. So, until and unless you are not perfect with the tables, these simple problems or the divisions cannot be solved easily. So, you will be stucking up somewhere else and you need to take out a multiplication table book and then you need to check out the answer. So I don't want you people to do in that way. So always, daily in the morning, once you're waking up, having your breakfast, everything, try to recap or try to revise the tables first in the morning so that you can become very perfect with the tables and you can do these divisions very easily. Now let us see how to find the quotient. Now here we have, I'll rub the board. So without repeated subtraction, without using the number line, using your imagination and using the multiplication tables especially, we have to write the quotient. Now 12 divided by 6. Next 42 divided by 7. 48 divided by 8. 50 divided by 10. Now suppose we have here 4 divisions. Okay, now without using number line, without repeated subtraction, we have to write the quotient. How do you write the quotient? You're going to write the quotient using the tables, multiplication tables. Now let us see. Now 12 divided by 6. You're going to divide the 12 with the 6. Now check, children, 12 in 6, how many times you will be getting it? 2 times. 6 twos are 12. So what is my answer? 2. Again 42 divided with 7. 42 in 7 how many times? 42 in 7 how many times? 6 times. 7 6 are 42. 48 in 8 how many times? 6 times. 8 6 are 48. 50 in 10 how many times? 5 times. 10 5s are 50. So these are our answers. So in order to write the quotient without using the number line and repeated subtraction, you are writing the quotient using the multiplication tables. Got it? So 12 divided by 6. 12 in 6 how many times? 2 times. 6 2s are 12. 42 divided with 7 is 6. 42 in 7, how many times? 6 times. 7, 6 are 42. 48 divided by 8 is 6. 48 in 8, how many times? 6 times. 8, 6 are 48. This is how, using the multiplication tables, you are finding out the quotients. Similarly, even you can find out the divisors using the dividend and the quotient. Let us see how to do that. Now, here you have to find the divisors. Till now, you have calculated or you have found out the quotients. Now, we need to find out the divisors. How to find? Now, here we have 48 divided with blank is equal to 6. 48 divided with blank is equal to 6. So here we have our dividend and we have our quotient also. What is missing? Divisor is missing. We have to find out the divisor. How? Simple children, 48 and 6 are there. In 48 or in 6 table, how many times the 48 will come across? 48 in 6, 8 times. 6, 8 are 48. Got it? Again, I'm telling you children, if you are perfect with the tables, it will be very easy for you to do these problems very quickly. Next, 54 divided with blank is equal to 7. Sorry, 6. 54 divided blank is equal to 6. So, 6 in 54, how many times? 6 nines are 54. Okay, next, 40 divided with blank is equal to 5. So, 40 in 5. 40 in 5. How many times? 8 times. 5 8s are 40. 24 divided with blank is equal to 6. 24 in 6. How many times? 6 4s are 20. That's it. So you are checking now the table of 6. Now 48 in 6. How many times? 8 times. Similarly, 54 in 6, 9 times. 40 in 5, 8 times. This is how you will find the divisors for the given questions. Okay, now let us learn how to find the dividends. This is very simple, children. How to find the dividends? Very simple. Now see here, blank divided by 7 is equal to 7. Now, we have to find our dividend. Dividend is missing here. What to do? Now, previously, divisor, to find out the quotient and divisor, you are taking the help of the multiplication, right? Similarly, here also you will need to know the tables, multiplication tables. Now, blank divided by 7, how to get? Now, here what are we doing? The divisor and the quotient. We have given here the divisor and the quotient. But there is no dividend. So what are we doing? You have to multiply the given divisor with the quotient to find out our dividend. What are you doing? You are multiplying. 7 sevens are 49. Okay. Next. Blank divided by 3 is equal to 30. Okay, now what do we need to do? We need to multiply divisor as well as quotient. Divisor and quotient, what are you doing? You are multiplying in order to get our dividend. So, 13 threes are 39. Okay, next. Blank divided with 9 is equal to 4. So, what are we going to do? We are going to multiply our divisor with the quotient. क्वेश्चन. 9 fours are 36. That's it. Very simple, children. So this is how you are finding out the quotient, finding out the divisor, and finding out the dividend. So in order to find out anything, children, in the division, again, what I'm going to say, need to be perfect with the tables. If you are perfect with the tables, you can solve the problems like this. Okay, children, fine. Now let us learn the properties of addition. What am I going to learn? The properties of addition. Now already for every operation, for every basic operation, we are learning the properties. For addition we have learned, for subtraction we have learned, multiplication, and also now we are going to learn about the divisions. Okay, now let us see what are the properties of the division. So what is the first one? When we divide a number by 1, when we divide a number by 1, the quotient is the number itself. What does it mean? 7 divided with 1 is nothing but 7. Any number on dividing with 1 will get back the same number. 7 divided by 1 is 7, 6 divided by 1 is 6, 100 divided by 1 is 100 itself. That is the first property. Next, when we divide a number by itself, on dividing a number by itself, the quotient is 1. What does it mean? 6 divided with 6, 1. So what are we doing? We are dividing the same number with the number itself. 6 divided with 6, 1. 7 divided with 7, 1. 100 divided with 100, 1. That's it. So 6 divided with 6, it means any number when we are dividing with the number itself, what is our quotient? 1. The third property, 0 divided by any number. When 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is 0. It means 0 divided by 9 is equal to 0. 0 divided by 10 is equal to 0. 0 divided by 100 is equal to 0. So on dividing 0 with any number, what is our quotient? 0 itself. Okay, now what is your fourth property? Fourth property, dividing any number with 0, opposite of this. 9 divided with 0, 10 divided with 0, 100 divided with 0. These are all, it has no meaning. There is no answer for this. It means the quotient itself has no meaning. So, a 0 can be divided with any number. Listen carefully, children. 0 can be divided with any number, but number cannot be divided by 0. That is, it has no meaning, or we say as undefined. So the proper term we use in mathematics for 9 divided by 0, that is number divided with 0, is undefined. We cannot have any answer for that. Okay, we cannot divide any number with 0. That is only. Okay, so these are the four properties. What are the four properties, children? Any number, or on dividing a number with 1, what are we getting? We are getting the dividend as the answer. What is our quotient? Dividend as the answer. Next, dividing the number with the number itself. On dividing the number with the number itself, what is our quotient? 1. What is the third property? 0 when divided with any number. 0 when divided with any number, what is the quotient? 0. Next, any number divided with 0. Any number divided with 0. zero has no meaning. It is undefined. What is it? It is undefined. So these are the four properties of division. It has no meaning. Exact term is undefined, children, or meaningless. Okay, so these are the four properties of division. So for today, we'll end the class here, and in the next class, we will be learning how to find the division using long division method, which is very important, and you'll be learning these divisions using long division method in your coming or further classes also. Got it, children? Hope you understood today's class. Okay, so the next class, when you're coming up, try to learn the tables. Okay, children, bye for today. Take care. Bye-bye.